Whatever happened there, enough pressure built up, which caused the explosion. I haven't read the detailed report. There is a report out there which talks about the reasons, but basically the whole thing came out, it blew up. So as you see, this there is a fire in there. As we have the fire, the stuff comes out, right? Of course it burns, but then you have a bunch of oil coming out. So pretty much you have a whole sea area which is covered with oil. So what happens? What happens? What happened in that case? According to BP, I believe it was BP, it was three companies. Halliburton, British Petroleum, and Deep Transocean, three companies. Transocean manages the rigs. I believe BP has permits, and Halliburton provides equipment, something like that. But the point is that there was so much oil, how did they take care of the disaster? There is a bacteria, eating bacteria, which eats oil, right? So they put a bunch of bacteria and it just ate up the oil. So the oil went out. And so you don't see the oil, you don't see these flashy images. All of a sudden, boom, good news, no more oil. Great, you have sun, you have clear water, you have no problem. You don't see it, you don't feel it, great. But the problem is that the bacteria that ate the oil, it didn't stop. It ate the oil, but then what? It started eating on other plankton and other things, microorganisms within the ocean, which really affected the environment, which some argue caused some kind of shifts in the environment. But of course, it's very difficult to prove causation because of this caused this, because there are many other factors which can be argued. So what's the point? What, this is customs broker class, right? Of course, everything we do here, it has a lot of connection to the world, including this stuff. It's very relevant. But in the world of offshore oil spill control, bacteria is just one way of fighting it. Another way of fighting it would be trying to capture the surface. Of course, it may be you have to have a still water, right? If you have stormy waters, this is not going to work. If you have huge waves, the oil is just going to escape. But if you have those booms and you can capture them, capture the oil, you can clean it up by having the oil captured by these booms and pulled to some kind of concentrated area where it can be sucked in. Of course, what's relevant here? Gulf region as well as Gulf of Alaska are US territories. So when the disaster strikes, it may be necessary to bring this stuff from overseas. And when you bring the stuff overseas to the customs territory of the United States, customs brokers are kind of there to as an essential park, as an essential link in the international trade. You have to bring it in order to use it. So no one says that, okay, it's a disaster, it's irrelevant. You still have to go through the customs clearance process. You still have to go through the formalities. This is when the customs brokers come in. So customs brokers are being asked to classify this. What's the core? This is a cork boom. So what is it? It's a cork. It's a tree-like substance, which is covered in a nylon and connected by ropes. So essentially, what you got? You got a mixture You got a product combination, which is made out of the following. Let's see. You have nylon, so you have a cork. Cork. You have nylon tie wraps. Nylon tie wraps. And you have a rope. So, in other words, the picture is as follows. The top covering is a nylon. Inside it is a cork, which makes the whole thing float. And the cork itself is connected internally with a rope. So otherwise, the nylon itself may not be strong enough to hold it. So you have a rope enforcement. So you have what? You have three products. You have a cork, you have a nylon tie wrap, and you have a rope. Obviously, it's a combined product. Obviously, it is has various materials. Here is the problem. We cannot classify. How do you classify? What principles do you use? Because remember, no one said that GRIs are not applicable here, right? So you must always, whenever classification is made, you must always use general rules of interpretation. What principle do you use here? And this was this came from customs. So whenever the reason I pulled this is because customs talked about it. Let's see. I even made the citation. So customs talked about it in New York binding ruling 855143. So this is where I get this from. I'm not making this stuff up. This comes from customs. Okay. So what do customs examiners, what do customs officials say? Well, customs officials say, this is article of cork. This is article of cork, or more specifically, article of natural cork. Even though cork booms are combination of materials, they are not classifiable under headings. What are the competing headings? Articles of rope. It's not article of rope, right? It's nylon, articles of nylon. It's not article of nylon, right? It's so by reason is it classifiable in two or more headings, automatically falls out because it can only be classifiable as article of cork, because cork cork forms the core. And because cork forms the core, customs examiners reasoned that the chapter 45, which provides for cork, is the only chapter which fits the provided product description. And here, by the way, for those of you who do not know cork is a material widely used in wine bottles, for example. When you open up the bottle, plastic is taking over. You have those plastic ones, but cork is still widely used. Champagne bottles, also cork is used. So articles of cork or articles of agglomerated cork, customs examiners have held that is an applicable provision, and hence the GRI 2B provision was held to be applicable for the cork boom in question. So in a cork boom example, what we have is we have a combination product which is not classifiable under two or more subheadings. It's classifiable only under one heading. Two or more heading. It is classified under one heading. And because it is a combination, it is not just cork. It is made out of nylon. There is a rope which holds the thing, the whole thing together. Under the GRI 2B, the product has been held to be classifiable as article of cork. So that leads us to general rule of interpretation 3, another big one. Any questions? So far we covered what? We covered GRI 1, a heavy hitter, GRI 2, which includes A and B, not so heavy. Our next is GRI 3, another heavy one, 4, 5, 6 is another heavy hitter. That's next on the list. Any questions?